What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about upgrading your SCCM to 2107, so let's get right into it. All right, so I have my SCCM console up and running. I am going to click on that file tab, and I am going to click on About Configuration Manager, and it's going to take me here. I am currently running version 2103. Okay. Now the next step that we need to do is get our hands on the early update ring 2107. I'm going to select it, right click on it, and run it as an administrator. You're going to get this dialog box, and I'm going to click OK, and you're done. Extraction is completed, and click OK. What it does is basically drops a PowerShell script. So I'm going to click on the start menu, going to type in Windows PowerShell, and I'm going to right click on the Windows PowerShell ISC and run it as an administrator, and it's going to start loading up. Once it loads up, we need to open that file. So that file was actually dropped inside the downloads folder. So I'm going to select it and open it up. Make sure you take a look at it. And once you're done, click on that power button to run it, and it's going to ask for your site server. Now for the site server, I like to enter the full qualified domain name. And once you're done, hit enter. And if everything works well, you should get the command completed successfully. Once you do that, we're going to open up your SCCM console. You're going to go inside administration, go inside updates and servicing, and then click on check for updates. You're going to get this nice little dialog box. So just click OK and give it some time. Eventually, Configuration Manager 2107 should pop up, and it should say downloading, which is a good thing. Once it's done downloading, you're going to get ready to install. So we're going to select it, right click on it, and you have two options. Now I'm going to automatically install the update pack because it does check for the prerequisites during the installation part. So we're going to pick that. We are definitely going to click on next. You're able to pick whatever features you want to include during the upgrade. Click next here. I'm gonna leave it as the default. Click next. Accept the license and terms. Click next. And from here, I'm not going to do a cloud attach. So I'm gonna basically check off these two options and click on next. A nice little summary, next. And it's gonna start doing its thing. And eventually you're going to get a green check mark, which is always a good thing, right? Click on close. And underneath the state column, it should say installing. Now, give it some time. It should change to checking for prerequisites, which is a good thing. If you select the Configuration Manager 2107 and then you go to the lower right-hand side where it says Show Status, you're going to click on that and it's going to take you here. You're going to basically select this status, right-click on it, and then click on Show Status. And it's going to give you a nice little bird's eye view of what's happening during the upgrade process. Now, when you come back, underneath the state column, it should say installing, which is always a good thing. Now, this process for me took a long time, so I left it be. When I came back the next day, I received this nice little warning banner, and it basically said there's a new version that needs to install into your server. So if you click on install the new console version, what's going to happen is everything's going to close. You're going to get this dialog box that is downloading the files. Eventually you're going to get this. And if everything works well, your console, your Configuration Manager console is going to launch up automatically and then take you here. Awesome. Now, if you click on the file tab and then go into About Configuration Manager, it's going to show you that you are in the latest version, which is 2107. Now, if you go inside Software, Overview, App Management, and then go inside Packages, make sure that your package, your client packages are up to date. Just select one, and at the very bottom, it should show you a content status. Now, I have a red and a green, and the reason why is because I have two DPs within my infrastructure, and one of the DPs right now is like offline. Now, the next thing that you could do is go inside Administration, Sites, and then click on your site, and we are going to basically pick on hierarchy settings, and it's going to take you here, and the tab that we would like to go into would be the client upgrade. If you want your clients within your infrastructure to automatically be upgraded, I advise you to check that option. For me, I don't have that, so that means I have to push it manually to update the clients within my environment. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.